how to use a procedural texture filter in Affinity Photo. This is going to be a very basic run through of that filter. So filters, colors, and procedural texture. Quickest way, just go to the presets at the top, just run through those, and you can see the various things, sine wave, fur, etc. Some of them have got custom inputs. You can modify the settings. Click apply, and that's it. You've got your filter, it's applied. However, the best way I think to use the filter is via the new live filter layer, colors and procedural texture. And the reason is it's a layer, a live filter layer. And you can modify that at any point. It also brings in blending modes and opacity into the equation. So you can see it there, layers, and you've got procedural texture appearing there. And again, you've got exactly the same as before. You've got presets, you've got a whole range of things, ripples, and so on and so on. Now, that was one I've created earlier. So what you can do, you can move the effect around. And the reason you can move it around is there's Rx and Ry in the equation. That's relative X and relative Y. So you can just move, really useful feature. There's a function there, OSCSC. Now, there's hundreds of other functions, and you can find those via the Affinity Help. That's the best source, Affinity Help. Now, you've got custom inputs there. You've got A and B. You can see that in the equation. You've got an A and B. They're multiplying the Rx and the Ry. Now, it's applied to all of the channels. You've got RGB at the side. You can see RGB. They're all selected. At the moment, I'm using all the channels. What I'm going to do, I'm going to create that function, but over the red and the green and the blue. Just going to change that to RA, both to RA, and I'm going to change that custom input. Now, as soon as you do that, the function doesn't work. It doesn't particularly matter at that point. So I'm just going to continue to work on that. So you've got RA times RX and RA times RY in the equation. And now what I'm going to do, I'm going to use that just in the red channel. But I'm now just going to go custom inputs. And you can see the custom inputs is R, so it's a real value. So you can just create a real value. So it's 1.02, 1.5, 1.6. I don't create three of them because what I want is one for red and I want one for green and I want one for blue. So I'm going to change those to RA, GA and BA. Obviously one for red, one for green and one for blue. And I'm going to set that. They're all to one by default. Just going to set that to, sometimes it just resets itself for some weird reason. Now, just going to go back. I'm going to give it a name, say red, green, and blue. Don't have to particularly, doesn't particularly matter, but it's nice. So when you come back to the equation later, you might think, what does it that those functions mean? But there you are, red, green, and blue. Just going to copy that. That's in there. And now if I just go red, so only available in the red at the moment, red channel. But what I want to do is click that little plus. And that adds another equation below and another one there. So I've got two additional equations. One's for red, one's for green, one's for blue. You can see they're now selected. Those red, green and blue along the thing. Okay, what I'm going to do is change the RA. I'm going to call it GA. I'm going to go to the other one, GA. So that's going to be just for the green channel. And I'm going to go to that one, make it B and BA. So you can see they match exactly the custom inputs. So now you can see the actual effect there over the side. So what you can do then, you can modify the BA and GA, and you can just up those down. And you can also input within the field. So you can just go to that, into that field, you can put 2.05. Otherwise, if you just use that plus up and down, it will just go 2.05, 3.05. What you can do, go to the right side menu, and then you can create a preset. You can save that preset. It's a very basic preset, so color plots, and you can give it a category as well. So I'm just going to call colored patterns, click create, and that's it. Save to your preset there. You can see it in your list. You've got various other ones as well, color plots. And now what you can do, you can continue to modify the value, say 2.4. It's a real value, so 2.4 come in. So make just subtle changes. Instead of just 2, 3, 4, you can make more subtle changes. And again, you make that, say, to 7.4, 5.4, and so on and so on. You can also use the blending modes. You can run through all the different blend modes. There's overlay, difference, color dodge, usual range, add, darker color, difference, and so on and so on. I'm going to go with normal there. You can also change the opacity as well. Right. So you've got that colour plots. What you can also do, you can add preset there. You've got the default settings. They're the default values that you've got. So that's the default, that point. Now you can just change one of the values, and then you can go over to that right side and create a preset for that preset. So I'm just going to call that fine one, and maybe change another value, such as a green value. And then again, go over to that right side drop down. Just move that around, of course, as before. Now, only goes down to zero. Right, going to set those values. Then go to that right side, create value preset. And again, give that a name. So all those settings are saved to that preset for that preset, color plots. So you can just select that and you see fine one, fine two, and you can just apply it or go back to the default as well. And they're the default settings. There's other settings as well. You've got angle, you've got various things. You might not have any use for those. Sometimes they're useful, sometimes they're not. So I've just gone for real in all those, but I could have used Z just as easily. There's also lots of other functions. So you might think, oh, I don't want the SC function for the OSC. I can use one of the other ones. I'm just going to SQ, and there's that SQ one there, or SIN, and put H in front of that. There's a OSCHSIN, as a sort of sine effect. And again, you can change the setting. You can see a variety of different functions just via that simple change. Say the Affinity Help has the whole list of them. It's also got the list of various values you can put into it. So there's a whole range of different settings. I'm not going to explain those in this video because it's best just to look in the Affinity Help to find out more about that. What you can also do, you can manipulate the function even more. You can maybe add a minus Rx if you want to do that. You can also maybe put noise into that. You can add the same function, modify the settings, maybe make that RB or GB. Just over and over again, just try different functions. And if it doesn't work, suddenly you made a mistake, it's quite possible, just a simple error in the equation and it will fail. You can always undo and just go back to the original function and then start again. So just get rid of it if it doesn't work, and then you've got the function back again. I do that all the time. I'm always editing things and changing things, and then suddenly it ceases to work, like I'm just doing there with the underscore, where I mean a minus or a plus. And then you've got noise functions as well. You can put noise, now put R instead of Rx, where I mean Rx. So then you've got some noise into that as well. Whole range of different things. You can just go around and try lots of things. And a great point, presets are a great starting point. You can run through all those, tweak them, modify them in numerous ways, and create your own wonderful presets that you can use as a layer filter effect. I hope you found this of interest. Please subscribe, always adding new videos, and also please add some comments, always appreciated. Thank you much.